Good evening, my name is Ryan Lures. I'm Director of Choral Activities here. Welcome to Grace Chapel at Lenoir-Rhyne University. Two words of gratitude for you and a few reminders before we begin. First, the gratitude. This is the 10th anniversary of Grace Chapel, of this space, of this event being held in this space. And I know many of you who attend this concert have been longtime supporters of Lenoir-Rhyne, and many of you helped make this building become a building. You supported Lenoir-Rhyne when this was in the planning processes 15 years ago and saw it to its fruition. I hope you see a return in investment for the student experience here and also for the community. About 1,200 people have walked through those doors, including you, in the past 72 hours to experience this concert. And we are fortunate, while sister institutions often have to have their concerts off-site, to have a space or they have it in their auditorium on campus, we have a beautiful space for a concert like this on our campus, and we are grateful for that. We're grateful for you for making that happen. The second thing, this event often serves as an opportunity to support our students who travel abroad with our music ensembles. Last year, this audience impacted every single student who went abroad to Spain and the brass ensemble and the a cappella choir. And in fact, there were a handful of students who didn't think they would be able to go to afford it, but because of the generosity of the people who came to this concert, we were able to sign up for the trip and travel to Spain. So your impact, as we have our free will offering during the organ solo tonight, know that support is directly impacting students' lives, because those trips are amazing. I feel I'm fortunate position to watch the transformation and the learning that happens. Some students who have never been on a plane, and some students certainly who've barely left the state, who get a chance to fly across the Atlantic Ocean and perform in some wonderful spaces in Europe. And then tonight, in our program, we're going to sing Joy to the World close to the end of the program, and you'll be standing for that. And then comes the Hallelujah Chorus without a break. And since you're standing, and that's the tradition, some of past audience have wondered if they should sing along. And I'm going to say, by all means, you have permission. If you know the Hallelujah Chorus, just sing along with us. You have permission to do that, and it's celebrated, in fact. So if you don't want to sing, you can just stand there and take it in. That's okay, too. And then finally, if you haven't silenced your devices already, do so. And this entire performance will perform without applause until the very end to help with the pacing. Thank you again for being here, and I hope you enjoy the program.
Thank you. In the beginning was the Word.
Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, Behold, the dwelling of God is with mortals. The dwelling of God is with us.
The dwelling of God is with us. The Word became flesh and made a dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Mary, full of grace, gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Later, an angel of the Lord appeared to the shepherds and said, Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to all on whom his favor rests. Peace to all.
He is coming soon. He is the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. A reading from Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Most holy and gracious God, you are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. We enter this world bearing your image and named as your precious children. You journey with us throughout our lives, and even when we come to the point of our death, you are there, welcoming us with open arms into blessed rest and everlasting peace. When death does come, we give you thanks for the promises you make to us. Death is not the end. Death does not get the final word. Instead, death is the beginning of glorious new life, where you reach out your divine hand and wipe the very tears from our eyes, and where we join with all the saints in worship, singing songs of joy and praise. As we continue our earthly journey, surround us with your mercy, grace, and love. Make us bold witnesses of all that you have done, are doing, and continue to do for all creation. Give us the courage we need to cry out for peace and justice in this world torn by warfare. For as you said to your prophet Ezekiel, you do not take pleasure in anyone's death. As we so sorely miss those who have died, help us trust in the promise of the resurrection to eternal life. Holy and gracious God, you are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. In all our beginnings and endings, open our eyes to see you in our midst, and fill our hearts with your peace. All this we ask in your holy and precious name. Amen.
Thank you. Okay.